Okay, guys, let's quickly look at Euro USD. Today I'm on Euro USD. As you can see on my screen, guys, we already have our analysis on Euro USD monthly time frame. So just to check on monthly first before we can go on with the analysis post. Okay, so if you can check, guys, on monthly, we had these highs here, which are taken out, and then it formed a new high there. So you know after the high is taken out, price should go back to that high before it continue going all the way up. So we might be looking at the breakout, we might be looking at the retest before price can break that trend line, the trend line that we have on this high here. Right, as you can see, it's very, very strong trend line. How do you identify a strong trend line? The more price bounced on one level, the stronger that level is. Okay. So let's continue, guys, and see if we can get more opportunities on how to trade this, because already you guys missed the trade on higher time frame. But the direction, guys, is the same. That the direction is good. Let me check if we can get Euro USD on lower time frame, so we take advantage of it. Okay, let's say for an example, let's start with daily time frame. We went from higher time frame, which is weekly, to a daily time frame. So what do you see on daily time frame? First of all, guys, we saw that price break this high here, right? Yeah. So if what's happening after price break that high, you have to know that price should come back to test that level, right? It should at least push back to test that level before it continue going all the way up, right? So let's take advantage of it, guys, and then see what we have, what we can do about this. Remember, today is NFP, guys. So looking at daily right now, what as you can see, this is a strong supply zone, right? You can say strong resistant, right? And then price has been ranging in some sort of a channel, right? As you can see there, a small rising channel. So as you can see, the candlestick that we have here, guys, it's a bearish pin bar. It's a sell signal, guys. Once you see that candlestick, you should know that we should sell the price going down. So from here, going all the way down to this level, price went there around, I think around 100 pips down, right? Okay, so let's just go to lower time frame to see what we have on lower time frame. Okay, so our lower time frame will be on, let's take for H4. Let's see what we have on H4. Okay, quickly, we have on H4, let's just mean, okay, yeah. Remember, guys, we have this level here that has been tested, has been broken on daily and never got tested. So prices always come back to that level there, right? So if we adjust it nicely there, to put it nicely there, okay. So the level that we are looking at now, guys, as you can see, price did this, right? And this is our channel that we draw on daily time frame, right? Okay, so looking at this, guys, you have to understand what is price telling you to do? What is price saying we should do now? So looking at this, we can say, okay, we have another supply zone here, right? There we go. So this level here, this movement here at the top here, might be a fake breakout. So let's take this one as your fake breakout, right? So now you might be looking at the price to do what? To go at least higher to this level here, right? If it went higher to that level and then it pushed down to break the trend line. So if it breaks the trend line, where is it gonna stop? It's gonna stop where it stopped before, which is this level, this side here. Look at this side here. So if you stopped here, remember, what is the rule of a head and shoulder? If this is your shoulder, this is your head, and then we're expecting a shoulder this side. The rule of a head and shoulder says the second leg to be equal to the first leg. So our first leg will be this one, so our second leg will be this one, right? So we're expecting price to come in and stop here after breaking the trend line, right? So after it breaks the trend line, it has to come back.